Welcome back to Your Property Empire. Now, joining me on the show tonight is Andrew Rechtman from realestate.com.au, and we've just been joined by Charles Tarbey, Chairman and Owner of Century 21 Australasia. Now, during the week, we had an email in from Frank in Sydney, and he asked, I've just received a letter from my strata managers as one of my other owners in my block has requested a special bylaw to prohibit smoking on the whole property. How do you think it will affect my ability to rent or sell the property in the future? Interesting question. Well, I've never heard this one before.
I'm not a smoker, so I guess it would be a good thing if you're not a smoker, because you can, but those people who don't smoke can really smell it. You know, when one
and more these days because no one's smoking.
Yeah, not a lot, but one of my 10 goes out in the back lane for a coffee, you can tell, you know, well before they get anywhere near you, they've been smoking. But
do you want to name and shame them?
It will. I'd love to. I think it would impact very much on their ability to rent, and I think also impact on the sale price.
But do you think from a positive or a negative?
Negative. I think it's a negative thing because people like to have a smoke, and you can't take that away. Well, gosh, there's nowhere else to go. What do you walk out in the street in your own home now and your own property and have a smoke? I think it could be quite a problem for values and for renters. Absolutely.
What are your thoughts? Do you have a little tick box on REA?
Yeah, I don't even have one for smoke-free zone yet, but there certainly are things like pet-friendly versus not pet-friendly. Mm. There's issues around making noise. There are buildings where you're not allowed to have excessive noise and parties, even parking on common property. My personal favourite is we have seen buildings where they say no excessive smoke from barbecues. So you've got to keep the barbie under control. It's very hard to know, and you'd have to talk for your reader. Yeah. They'd have to ask what is the dynamic in that particular building. Talk to the tenants, to the tenants' mind. I tend to agree with Charles.
How do you police it though? I mean, really,
there's got to be a better way than putting in a bylaw in the building to stop smoking, and it does feel like it stepped over that personal.
You might have to take a puff and blow it through a long straw up to the balcony up above you or something. So it looks like
some corporate buildings these days that ban the smokers from being out the front because it's a bad image for the company as well, isn't it?
It is. I think it's a very bad image for any business when you've got people standing out the front having a smoke. I know some companies where people stand out front and have a drink. You know, I've got a can of VB in their hand and it never looks good. So the back lane is always the best place. But still, you're going to end up removing a whole series of situations. Pet friendly is great because a lot of people have a small pet and I don't see that as an issue unless it makes too much noise. But boy, oh boy, you're getting really into it if you're going to start smoking.
But again, with the pet-friendly thing is, if you didn't like pets and you found they're noisy, could that reduce buyers in the building?
Well, anything that reduces the opportunity to expose your property to more sellers than normal is always going to have an impact on your price. It always has.
Yeah.
Limitations is like a first-home buyer's property is going to have a million buyers looking at it. A super residence in the eastern suburbs or top area of any part of Sydney is going to have 10 buyers looking at it.
I think it depends on community standards as well. So at some point, it's going to flip the other way, which is I won't buy in a building that allows smoking. So we're seeing that change in community standards over time. It started, I remember, going on airlines where you could smoke on airlines not that long ago, and you could smoke in bars and
parks. Having the pet friendly, for instance, then there's a lot of people that won't rent. So my philosophy on rent vesting is all good financially, but if you've got a pet then, or you've got a dog, then suddenly you can't do the renting thing. So that's where someone may pay a premium to get into pet friendly, couldn't it?
They may, but I think people just don't tell you they have a pet.
Yeah.
I mean, my experience in real estate is that you don't get the full picture on what's really going on when somebody's renting. So, and I'm sure that's your experience too. You rent a property out to one person and in some parts of medium density you find 10 people living in the property.
Yeah. So would you go with the bylaw or would you go against it, do you think? And obviously we're not giving financial advice here.
Not giving financial advice here. I'd encourage you to talk to the tenants and see what they think. If there's a general mood that they shouldn't be smoking, I'd probably be in support of it. But I think in the long term, it probably devalues the property if you get the bylaw.
I would be against it, and I'm a non-smoker.
Now, for more information on things to consider when buying a property, you can always download a copy of my book for free at yourempire.com.au. I specifically do not cover the smoking thing, so I don't know what the answer is, but go with it and speak to the various other people. All right, Charles, tell us about your graphs and what's happening around the country.
Oh, yeah.